This video is brought to you by Fiverr.com. Click on the link in the description below and make any purchase to support this channel.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
So let's check out a problem regarding lattice energy. The question reads, for each pair of compounds, state which one has the greater lattice energy. So we have Al2O3 versus Al2SE3, ZNO versus NaCl, MgF2 versus MgI2, and LiF versus MgO. So think a little bit about what goes into lattice energy. What would make a particular ionic compound have a greater or lesser lattice energy? Think about that and give this question a try. So to start, let's just talk a little bit about lattice energy. Lattice energy is calculated this way. We have a constant C, and then we have Z plus and Z minus. Those are the charges on the ions. So if we have plus 1 and minus 1, plus 2 and minus 2, etc., that's where the charges go. And then we have this R value that represents interionic distance, or how far apart the centers of each ion are away from each other. And that has to do with the size of the ions, because the bigger they are, the farther apart the centers will be. So in order to get a greater lattice energy, in order for that value to be bigger, we can have greater charges or larger values. We can have larger Z values, right? Because if those Z values get bigger, the fraction gets bigger because those are in the numerator. So greater values for those charges will result in a greater lattice energy, or a smaller interionic distance will also result in a greater lattice energy. Because if we have smaller ions and we have a smaller interionic distance, then that value in the denominator will get smaller, and as a result, the whole fraction will become larger. So the two ways to get a greater lattice energy are greater charges and a smaller interionic distance, or smaller ions. So as we go through these, just to remind ourselves, greater charges or smaller ions equals more energy. So let's get our first example, Al2O3 versus Al2SE3. So we have aluminum in each. That's not gonna change. We have aluminum and aluminum. So let's compare what's different. We have O3 and we have SE3. What do we know that is different about these elements? Well, they're in the same group, so they have the same common charge, so the charges are the same here. That's not going to help. However, oxygen is smaller than selenium. So that means Al2O3 will have the smaller interionic distance because it has smaller ions, and therefore that compound has a greater lattice energy. Now for the second example, we have zinc oxide versus sodium chloride. Well, here we do have different charges. Zinc oxide, we know that oxides are 2 minus, so zinc must be 2 plus. So we have a 2 plus cation and a 2 minus anion. And then sodium chloride, we know that those are going to be plus 1 and minus 1. So here we're looking at the magnitudes of the charges. If zinc oxide has 2 plus and 2 minus, in that fraction, we're going to have 2 and 2 up top versus 1 and 1. That's going to be a factor of 4. So without even really having to look at interionic distance, we know that zinc oxide is going to have a greater lattice energy. Now looking at magnesium fluoride versus magnesium iodide. Once again, magnesium is the same, so let's look at fluorine and iodine. Those are in the same group, so they're going to have the same common charge. They will both become minus 1 to become fluoride and iodide, so it's not about charge. But we know that iodide is much larger than fluoride. So because fluoride is so much smaller than iodide, magnesium fluoride has a smaller interionic distance than magnesium iodide. So smaller ions, smaller interionic distance, magnesium fluoride is going to have a stronger or a greater lattice energy. Lastly, looking at lithium fluoride versus magnesium oxide. Let's look at the charges. Lithium fluoride, those are going to commonly make plus 1 and minus 1 charges. And magnesium oxide, we've got 2 plus and 2 minus. So because magnesium oxide has greater charges, that is going to have the greater lattice energy. So that is the answer for these four.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.